Research in education differs from research in other areas in a number of ways, but I'm going to talk about two of them here. One of those ways is the difficulty we have controlling all the variables at play in educational research. We have interactions amongst students and teachers, amongst the classroom, amongst the broader school culture, and we can't control for all of those things. So one of our difficulties is in understanding the full range of different variables and dynamics at play. Another interesting thing in educational research is that very often we're not just interested in understanding learning or understanding education. I think most of us get into this field because we want to improve it. We want to help students learn better. And so when you're sitting in a classroom observing something and you recognize a reason why a student's having trouble learning some material, it's very difficult not to intervene and help them because that's why we're doing this. And yet if our main goal is to understand learning, then we can't do that. So for these reasons, among others, a field exists, especially in educational research, although it exists elsewhere as well, called design-based research. Design-based research is the idea of creating something and then using that something, that tool, that protocol, that behavior, as a probe into classroom interaction or the learning process. What we do here is effectively build a tool that would work if our theory of learning is accurate. For example, if we're interested in individualized feedback. If we believe that students learn better from individualized feedback, we would create a tool that uses individualized feedback or gives students individualized feedback. And then based on whether or not that tool actually improves learning, we would reflect back on our original theory. If the tool gives students individualized feedback and they don't improve in their understanding of some material, then we might reflect and say that theory that I used to justify that tool was actually false. I don't have any evidence to defend the idea that that's useful. But then if that tool actually does work, we would say, because I developed a tool that improved individualized feedback and because students learned as a result, my theory about individualized feedback helping learning must be accurate. So in design-based research, we're designing tools, then using those tools as probes into the phenomenon that those tools are designed to address.